PCVR is a great way to play some of the best virtual reality games in high quality. Standalone is good and all since there's no pesky cable, but there are so many beautiful games like Stormland, Asgard's Wrath, and No Man's Sky that you just can't get on a Meta Quest. The Vision Pro doesn't have any official Steam VR support, because even if they did, Valve no longer supports Steam VR on macOS, so there wouldn't be any games to play. There's no way that Apple would ever consider supporting using Windows PCs for Steam VR on the headset, so that idea is dead in the water. The Vision Pro doesn't have any ports to connect to a PC anyways, unless you buy the $300 developer strap, of course. I've mentioned this a billion times already, but the best and only way to play Steam VR games on the headset is through ALVR, allowing for a wireless Epic gaming experience. For me, it's worked well, and with VR controllers like the Surreal Touch or the newly supported PSVR 2 one, I'm sure it could be considered on par with virtual desktop on the Quest, depending on your connection strength. I highly doubt Apple will ever fully support any sort of wireless or tethered PCVR experiences. They've always seemed pretty checked out of the gaming industry as a whole. I think this is especially the case with the Vision Pro, a $3,500 headset with a small user base, and even smaller user base that want to play VR on it. Maybe for the Vision Air or future iterations, but we definitely won't see PCVR currently. Now, I say that, but we did get a very tiny glimmer of hope with Vision OS 26. Apple released a developer feature that allows for rendering and streaming virtual reality experiences from a Mac to the Vision Pro. They don't really go into too much detail, but it basically uses a Mac to experience your game or app in Xcode on the Vision Pro, utilizing the Mac's powerful chip. The Vision Pro has an M2 chip, which is pretty powerful compared to other headsets. However, if you have a Mac with an M3 Ultra or newer, you'd basically have a lot of power that could be used for a graphically intensive VR game made in Xcode, for example. I highly doubt it, but maybe in a perfect world, this could be used as a precursor for allowing some sort of PCVR on the headset. A button in the control center that I can just tap on and then go straight into my Mac's PCVR interface to play a streamed game of No Man's Sky would be awesome. If you call it Cope, then you're probably right, but it doesn't hurt to dream. Anyways, that's all for today, but make sure to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and take care!